local forecast starts now with Chief Meteorologist Eric Finkenbinder.
I think most of us were stuck in the 30s today. Lots of sunshine, look nice, and tomorrow's going to be quite similar. So it's dry air, it's cold air, and that does, again, have at least some play. It does play a part moving into Thursday morning, especially during those morning hours before we start to get that nudge of some milder air, and we'll talk about that in a moment. Also, 32, Lebanon Valley College in Annville, Lebanon County. When you look at the picture, hey, we got the cold air right over top of us, and I mean, it just sounds like, and it feels like, boy, this could really be it. The Frosty the Snowman type of snow, right? We'll see a little bit of it, but I think ice would be really the biggest opportunity for us. And that ice groups together the sleet and freezing rain. So some that bounces, some that sticks. Both of those ice type of scenarios are likely to be happening across the mid-state. But you can see we've got it anywhere from the Dakotas off into Denver. That's milder air allowing a rain. Now we're also getting some severe weather across the south, which is kind of typical for this kind of system. Hearing about severe weather in the south and really blizzard-like conditions across the north. By the time it reaches here, it's got plenty of moisture to work with. We do have moisture, but we just don't have the amount of cold aloft. Again, at the surface, it's going to feel cold and it's going to feel raw, and we are cold enough to actually keep anything frozen for a time. We go into tomorrow and we're quiet. Those clouds increase throughout the day. It's Thursday morning, and I do believe it's going to be before sunrise, and that's important. So our weather team's going to be watching this, and I'm sure we're going to be out just showing you what the roads do look like, road conditions by Thursday morning. This is 5:30 a.m. Areas in pink, that is an indication of ice. Could it be snow and sleet or some pockets of freezing rain and sleet? Again, there's sort of different ways of, or I should say, different precip types that are going to be happening all across the mid-state all at one time. So we can't just have a blanket type of forecast. So it looks like icing is going to be the greatest challenge for us. There will be some snow accumulation, but when you get farther south, those of us in York, Adams, Lancaster, that is where we see our best chance of just maybe getting a glaze of ice then to rain. And we're going to be seeing rain south of Harrisburg for a majority of this and heading into then Thursday evening. But you get north of Harrisburg, that's when we could maybe see some accumulating snow. It all begins to wrap up then moving into Friday morning. And we still have some leftovers first thing Friday morning, but by Friday afternoon, it's pretty much done. And we do have a quiet but cold weekend. So travel conditions Thursday, morning hours, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 o'clock. I'd say all the way through noon is going to be a bit tricky. Until we get into the afternoon, we get some more milder air, and that will help us out. But I still think travel is going to be a little tricky during the morning hours. If we were to create a map right now, I do think we're going to be able to kind of fine tune this a bit more. But I would say areas in white indicating our better chances of maybe seeing at least a little bit of snow accumulation before we do get some icing. And then a slushy mix, Lancaster, York, Southern Dauphin into Adams counties. So for the most part, you kind of get the idea. This is not going to be that fun type of storm. It's kind of like a bummer to the weather team, too, because we're like, all right, could this be our first white Christmas that we've seen since 2012?
Yeah.
Well, we'll see. We still have other chances, but let's get through.